YouTube, what's going on? It's Mesa back at it with some Destiny 2. Alright folks, time for an obligatory ultimate preparation guide for the Warmind DLC that's going to be hitting May 8th. In this video, we're going to go through all the things that I am doing or have been doing to prepare for this DLC to hit May 8th. That's going to include a number of things, things that you might want to hold on to, things that you might want to cash in right now. But the goal is going to be a few things. One, get gear quickly. I'm going to assume there's going to be a new max power level. I would like to hit it rather quickly. However, I do hope they make us grind for it. But most importantly, I want new weapons, and I want to get new weapons fast. And also, we are getting exotic weapon masterworks coming in May with 1.2.0. I want all of it, so let's get into it. So let's talk about vendors here. Now, when Curse of Osiris hit, only four places gave you new gear. And we're gonna mainly stay on the weapon topic here. I want new weapons. I want new toys to play with. So when Curse of Osiris hit, Brother Vance had new weapons, right? You could forge them and also get them from just cashing in tokens to Brother Vance and Mercury. However, back at the tower, Lord Shaxx and Commander Zavala and Banshee all had new stuff. So, first recommendation is going to hoard your Crucible tokens, your Vanguard tokens, and your Gunsmith materials. I know, common sense, right? I personally love to buy these Boons of the Crucible and Boons of the Vanguard. Shaxx sells them for 25 legendary shards, Zavala sells them for 10 legendary shards, and I pop one before each strike, and I pop one before each Crucible match. So you can see here, I've got plenty of Crucible tokens, I have way more Vanguard tokens, and I have a decent amount of Gunsmith materials. However, I guarantee you in the comment section, a number of you are going to say you have 2, 3, 4,000 Gunsmith materials, but Shaxx, Zavala, and Banshee, they're more than likely going to have new gear. Moving on to the vendors over on the destinations like the EDZ, good old Failsafe, on Nessus, we got Sloan on Titan. They did not refresh, or I don't believe they did, with any new weapons. However, they're going to be a good source of Masterwork cores. That's another thing that I'm trying to hoard myself right now. I have a number of my favorite weapons that I've got all Masterworked out. However, when 1.2.0 hits, we are going to be getting Masterwork exotic weapons. And we don't know how many Masterwork cores it's going to take to turn an exotic weapon into a Masterwork. So now I could just cash all these in now and probably get a number of Masterworks to just dismantle because I've made all my favorite weapons into Masterworks. But you know what? I'm saving them. You know, you just never know. They might refresh them with new weapons. I doubt it for this DLC, but I could see them down the road when we get the DLC in September. Hopefully all the destinations get new stuff, and especially if they're doing weapon slot changes, weapon randomization. Please, Bungie, make all of the destination vendors relevant when we're playing Destiny 2 come September. So I'm also hoarding the planetary materials, but to be frank, guys, if you want to get tokens really fast from either destinations or Crucible or even Vanguard, look, go into each character and do the daily challenge, okay? You get bonus tokens from doing the daily challenges, and when you go into each destination, they're really simple, guys. It's three things. On Nessus today, it was kill 5 Minotaurs, do 1 public event, and clear a lost sector. Boom, you got yourself a whole bunch of extra Nessus tokens. So do your daily challenges for each destination. If you want to hoard your destination tokens, make sure you do on each character. Remember, it's different for each character. Do your Vanguard challenges, and then also do your Crucible challenges. When it comes to engrams, exotics, bright engrams, all that sort of stuff, just get rid of all of them, okay? I don't believe we're going to be getting anything new from old engrams. When Curse of Osiris hit, I had each character completely filled with exotic engrams and some legendaries, and they gave me all old stuff. So get rid of them now, cash them in. You could get yourself some Masterworks, and you can break them down into Masterwork cores. Let's talk about good old Banshee. So, as I recommended before, hold on to your weapon parts, turn them in after the Warmind hits. Hopefully you'll get some new stuff. One thing also is mods, okay? We want to hoard mods. Now, you're probably looking at my glimmer here at 26,000. How do you not have 100,000? Here's why. Every time I hit 100,000 glimmer, I come here and I buy a bunch of random mods. Why? Because I'm hoarding modifications, because when the new gear hits, I want to have tons of mods to put on them. They're like, Sean, you don't have anything here except, all right, you have a number of the elements, the elemental mods for your weapons. Where's everything else? Well, it's all sitting in my vault, okay? I'm not wasting any time with keeping them on my character, because if I don't need them, I will dismantle them. Because another thing, too, we'll just do this right here, is I'm also trying to hoard some of these here, these mod components, because more than likely, I want to try to stock up on the kinetic mod, that plus 5. Do I have any of them here? We're going to go down right here. Here's like, all right, so I have 4 left. So the next time I log in, and you want to check in daily and see if Banshee is selling one, if he sells a kinetic attack mod, it's going to be 5 mod components and 10 legendary shards. I'm going to be loading up on those also prior to May 8th. So if you see something here that you don't necessarily need, what's this? Improves handling for equipped energy weapon, and that's a Warlock bond. All right, so you know what? I want to hold that. I want to hold on to that for my Warlock here. But if there was something that I know I definitely wouldn't use, and I can't find any right now. You know what? I don't like to use the melee mods, the one that just gives you extra melee energy, unless I'm on my Hunter. But if I saw one here, I would get it, I would trade it in, and then I would dismantle it so I can stock up on these things here, mod components, come back to Banshee after the Warmind hits, and then hopefully, well actually even before the Warmind hits, and buy some of those kinetic attack mods. Now we might as well get Eververse out of the way too, but basically, everything I get from Eververse, I simply dismantle, right? So here, we're gonna pop an Engram. What do I got? All right, I got some shaders and I got a Sparrow. So rather than stocking up on shaders, I just immediately start getting rid of those shaders. And even the Sparrows and some of the exotic stuff, if you don't need it, get rid of it. Let's see here. This vehicle takes less time to summon. All right, we're going to dismantle this Curse of Foresight because I already have that on one of my other characters. And let's see, what do we get? A whopping 450. Okay, what about these legendaries? What are you going to give me? Gonna give me, okay, not bad. All right, so yeah, anything you get, if you have a duplicate Ghost Shell, use Destiny Item Manager. If you're on a PC or Mac, just load it up. It's a Google Chrome plugin, but basically search duplicates, and that's what I do. That's how I manage all my shaders. You're probably like, how are your shaders not filled up? Well, one is, as soon as I get something, I just dismantle it, because a lot of times when you complete these challenges or you get an Engram, you just get three, I break them down, I get some Glimmer. But as soon as I get things from Eververse Engrams, I just immediately break them down for Bright Dust, and including Sparrows, Ghost Shells, all that sort of stuff. So right now, look, I have 7 G's worth of Bright Dust. So when she refreshes, if she gets some cool stuff, I more than likely will buy it from her and not have to spend any silver. I do buy these Fire Team Medallions a lot, but you get the idea, guys. And also with the whole duplicates thing, this one here, Blue Geometry here, all right, I get this like crazy. And I'm looking at Destiny Item Manager right now, and it looks like I've got 740. So what I do is I just type in duplicate, and I just start moving things over into my vault. And my vault actually is not full at all. I dismantle anything that I feel like I'm not going to use or not need. So just dismantle, alright, Golden Trace, I like that. But Metallic Sunrise, not one of my favorite shaders, so I'm just going to keep dismantling it. Another thing you might consider doing, and I put this towards the end because I don't really think it's worth your while right now. See, Ikora Rey, when you do her meditations, they're fun and all, but she has nothing except armor. However, that armor could give you higher power stuff when the Warmind hits. You might want to do your story missions on, because look, you do 3 on each character per week. All right, you're going to get a number of tokens. I don't exactly know how many of those Vanguard Research tokens you get. I have 46 right now. Who knows? She might get a refresh on weapons. I doubt it. But more than likely, she's going to be another way to get some high power gear rather quickly. So these are easy to do. They're fun. Just to chime in on the whole story thing, I really hope they do revamp the way that we... Look, we want to play the old story missions, alright? I enjoyed the weekly story playlist in Destiny 1. We all loved the story when Destiny 2 first came out, and I feel like only having 3 stories to choose from each week, not very much fun. I hope this gets a revamp, and of course, I will try to bring this up when I go to the Destiny Community Summit next week. So I think that pretty much covers everything that I think you should hoard. However, I am going to bring up one or two other things. You know what? Iron Banner 6v6 is coming this week. Now, I don't think he's bringing anything that I want in particular. So you know what? I might play the heck out of Iron Banner, do the daily challenges on all 3 characters each week, just hoard tons of Iron Banner tokens, because remember, Iron Banner tokens do not go away. They stay with you in between Iron Banners, so if you don't see anything you like, it'll carry over to the next Iron Banner. So this next Iron Banner, I'm going to hold on to these and just hoard the heck out of them, because look, I can't wait to play 6v6 Iron Banner Control. I'm going to get as many tokens as I can, not use them on Lord Garden Saladin, because I don't need anything. I don't want to play Destiny. I don't need the ornaments. I don't need the armor. I already have all the weapons. So I want to save this for the next Iron Banner, because more than likely, he'll refresh with new stuff. Might as well talk about the Emperor Kallus tokens. If you're a raider, this probably doesn't apply to you. You already have tons of these things. More than likely, Benedict 99, because he sells gear every single week. Okay, more than likely, when the new raid lair hits, hopefully he'll rotate his stock and we'll be able to buy some of the new raid lair gear as well as weapons. Another thing I want to touch on too is a lot of people tweet me this. You see it says right there, maximum power this can be infused to is 360. That's a glitch or a placeholder. I'm positive of that. When Destiny 2 first came out, it said 350 right there. Then when Curse of Osiris hit, it said 360. So everyone's making videos that max power level 360. No. It's a glitch, I think, or just a placeholder. We have no idea what the next power level is. However, from 335 to 360, you know what? I want to see. You know what? Bungie, take us to 400, okay? Make us really grind for this next DLC, because in my opinion, we as Destiny players, when you throw a number in front of us, we will grind for it. Anyway, I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, do me a favor. Well, first off, leave me a hashtag, made it to the end, if you did make it to the end, and do me a favor, drop a like in this video, only if you see fit. Follow me on the Twitter, at MesaSean, check out my stream, usually and always on YouTube, and that's it. I'm out of here like Vladimir.